Insanity is doing the exact same fucking thing over and over again, expecting shit to change. That is crazy. But the first time somebody told me that, I don't know, I thought they were bullshitting me, so boom, I shot them. The thing is, okay, he was right.
This is one of the many examples of using blocking to work on your animations. Now, what is blocking? If you guys have seen Valve's initial tutorials on SFM, they show you how to do pose to pose. This is kind of like that, except I believe they did it with the motion editor, where it is blocking. You're going to be doing in the graph editor. So what I have here is a very old video done around the time Far Cry 3 came out. Well, I think I got it from the video that released of this little scene here. So, like I said, this has been an old video. I've been going back and forth on, you can see how many snipers I've had. I've been animating. How deep into it I've gotten with some of these. And then, so I'll just put up a new one. I initially had the animation copy the original video in terms of movement and all that, where Voss is sitting on a box and getting... then he gets up and starts walking around. But I decided to kind of free flow it and do what I thought would be interesting animation wise to go with the audio. And the initial phase of that is what you just saw. I'll turn off the lighting for you now. With blocking, you're going to want to, if you're using audio, certain parts of the audio, like, let's see.
Same fucking thing.
Like, there's audio cues where you'll want to drop in, like, a very extreme pose or something, which is what I've done throughout this video, or this project so far. Now, blocking, you're going to start by building up the overall path of your character and all that. So, let's say, for instance, I want him to walk over to the wall, lean against the wall. Well, you would start by having him stand, and then I would probably put another one, another keyframe over by the wall. So we'd have that, this pose. And then from there, I'd probably put one in the middle, like that. Now, the trick here is, you always want to keep your keyframes in a stepped tangents, I believe this is. I usually uncheck that and make sure this stays stepped. But that's how you'll work. Stepping will make it much easier to edit these keyframes, because when your keyframes are splined, the computer's calculating what the bones are going to be doing when they transition between your keyframes. So it's kind of adding clutter to stuff that you want to just go ahead and start editing. So keep it stepped until you have a couple poses already set up. And then the best part about this, and what really is gonna make it much easier for you guys, is let's do this first of all. Like I said, we're gonna have him stand, walk over. So let me make a copy of this just so I can show you something here. So we'll get rid of all this stuff just so we have the frames I was talking about. All right. So we'll do it like that. So standing there. Well, we'll do. He's standing there, and then see. Sometimes it splines these by itself, so we gotta every so often keep re-stepping them. But we'll have him standing there, and then over by the wall. And then, like I said, we'll grab his root, and then put one in the middle, and then maybe turn him. So now we have this. And then boom. Now back to what I was saying. The most easy or the best part about blocking is you don't have to animate all this yourself. Like I was saying earlier, the computer, when the keyframes are splined, the computer will calculate what this pose is going to transition into to get to this pose. So between keyframes, the computer is going to be doing all the animating for you. Now, let's say, and this will help you save time as well. So let's say, okay, I want to put another keyframe here, but I don't feel like, you know, grabbing the root, moving it forward, and turning him. So the easiest thing to do is highlight your character. So all the bones are selected. Select all your keyframes. Spline them, and here we're gonna see what I'm saying. The computer did it for me. I'm gonna save that calculation that it just did between the two keyframes, and then we'll go back, highlight, step. So now all you have to do is just edit the keyframe ever so slightly, you know, turn him a bit more, you know, move his arm, move his legs and whatnot, and then, you know, boom. And then you'll just keep doing that. So, what I mean by that, again, boom, I can even go here and boom, and select all. You see what I'm saying? So, once again, let's go over this. You'll create your initial poses. And then in between those poses, you can spline the keyframes to get that transitional animation completed for you by the computer or the program, whatever, and make a keyframe of that to save that animation or that pose that was just completed, and then tweak it a little bit. So you just keep doing that over and over again until you have, like, if I show you one of these older ones, until you have something like this, which is like a wall. And I'll say right now that I don't use blocking, even though I should, because these past couple days I was looking back into it. Something I learned early on but never really used, because I would just go in and put this another thing, I keep it on the default bone thing, but I would go in, change the rig to biped simple, and just start, you know, let me move the leg, let me move this, even though now I'm realizing this would make it so much easier for me. So I will be using this for future animations. I'm probably gonna work on this. It's definitely gonna take longer than using the way that I used before, the process that I use, which is just, you know, going in and animating without, you know, posing everything out. So the way I do it is quicker, but it doesn't look as good, as you can tell. So don't, like me, think quality or quantity over quality. You want quality over quantity. You want to put out good videos, but less often, because you're going to be putting more time into them rather than putting out, you know, 5 videos a week and not putting any effort. So, once again, that's blocking, pose to pose, kind of, or is. Create your poses, spline, use spline to get your transitional poses between your poses that you set up. And you just keep working on it. Now, there is a, like I've said in another video, there's a YouTube channel I use called Endless Reference. They have like slow motion videos of people walking, which is really helpful for learning to animate a walking cycle or whatever you call it. So I implore you guys to check that out and to look up videos. Like if you're doing a fighting scene, look up reference. Don't be, don't think that you, by using reference, you're not good enough or whatever. Everybody, even a professional, uses reference. Because not everybody's going to remember every little detail that a human does. You'll just know the basics. So always gather your references. Even as an artist like me, I have, you know, folders of photo reference for anatomy and all that. So don't think that using reference is a bad thing. So another thing, I suggest you guys grab an audio, say from... like I have from Far Cry 3, use that audio as your groundwork to then create your poses, and that'll take the storytelling out of it, so you just animate to the audio. And you can use that as a training process or whatever. So, that is blocking in a nutshell. Very simple. Time-consuming, but the end product will be better than just rushing in and without planning it out. So, plan it out, take your time, get your reference, and your videos are going to be good. So, if you enjoyed this tutorial, this insight into blocking, please leave a thumbs up and leave a comment. Tell me what you think about it. If you made it this far into the video, let me know what you asked Santa for. I am still waiting for that $1 million I keep asking him for, but we'll see. If you guys haven't already, please watch my previous video. Head Crusher is the name. Let me know what you think. Thank you for watching. Subscribe if you haven't already, and if I don't talk to you guys anytime soon, you all have a wonderful Christmas and a happy New Year. Goodbye.